Hello students, today we are going to study the fifth chapter, that is image enhancement in the spatial domain. So what is meant by the image enhancement? The principal objective of the enhancement is nothing but it is a process an image so that the result is more suitable than the original image for the specific application. So image enhancement approaches falls into the two broad categories. One is the spatial domain methods and second one is the frequency domain method. So we enhances the or we increase the some properties of the image or enhances the some properties of the image so that it is suitable for the some specific application. So the image enhancement can be done by the two methods. One is the spatial domain method and second one is the frequency domain method. So the term spatial domains means the image plane itself, and the approaches in these categories are based on the direct manipulation of pixel in an image. So the spatial domain is nothing but the image itself, whatever the process is done on the image itself and its direct manipulation on the pixel in an image. So spatial domain can be process is done by this equation g of xy is equal to t of f of xy, where f of xy is the your input image, g of xy is your processed image, and t is the operator on f. F is nothing but the intensity of that pixel defined over the neighborhood of f of xy. Next, the neighborhood of point xy can be explained by using the square or rectangular sub image area centered at xy. So this is the square or the plane, rectangular plane of the image. The neighborhood about the point, the center of sub image, is moved from the pixel to pixel starting from the top left corner. So the center is moved, or the center of sub image is moved from the top left corner by the pixel to pixel, and the operator t is applied to each location of xy. Xy is that pixel point, so t operator or transformed operator is applied on the each pixel of the image to find the next processed image g of xy at the particular location. The process utilizes only the pixel in the area of the image spanned by the neighborhood. So there are some transformation methods for the enhancement. Some basic gray level transformations are, so it is the simplest form of the transformation when the image in this size. In this case, the processed image, that is a G image, depends only on the value of F, that is intensity at that pixel XY, and the T becomes a gray level transformation function of the forms. The gray level transformation function is defined as a S is equal to T of R, that is transformation of R, and the R is the gray level of that particular pixel f of xy, and s is the gray level of g of xy. So g of xy, we already defined g of xy is the processed image at that point g xy. Because the enhancement at any point in an image depends only on the gray level at that point, so gray level it is depend upon the gray level of that point, and the technique in this categories are referred to as the point processing, because pixel by pixel enhancing done, so we can call it as a point processing. So there are basically three kind of the gray level transformation. So the first gray level transformation is the point processing, or we can call it as a contrast scratching. The contrast scratching is nothing but it produces an image of the highest contrast than the original. So it is one kind of the compression expansion type. The operation is performed by darkening the levels below the M and the brightening the levels above the M. Suppose if you consider this graph, if your M value is towards the left, so you will get the darkening of the image. And if M value above the pixel value above the M, so you will get the brightening of the levels in an original image. In this technique, the value of R below M is compressed. So if R value is less than m, so you will get the compressed by the transformation. And if that is compressed transformation function into the narrow range of s toward the black, so it goes to the black side or black color, the opposite effects takes place for the value of r above the m. So above the m, if r value is less than m, so you will get the darkening of the image, and if r value is above the m, so you will get the brightening of the image. So that is, r value is less than m, so it is a nothing but the compressed by the transformation function, and r value is greater than m, so it is expansion by the transformation function. So here is the function that is gray level transformation for the contrast enhancement. So second is the thresholding function. So it is limiting the case where T of R produces the two levels binary image. The value below the M are transformed as a black and the above the M is transformed as a white. So it shows in the previous figure. So if the value below M is transformed as a black color or black, and two binary represents, and the value above the M represents the value above the M represents the white color. So it is nothing but the thresholding function. So basic gray level transformation, these are the simplest image enhancement techniques, that is nothing but the image negative. So image negative, these are the some simplest image enhancement technique, that is image negative. The negative of in an image with the gray levels in the range of 0 to L minus 1 is obtained by using the negative transformation, and the expression for the negative negative transformation is S is equal to L minus 1 minus R. The retrieving the intensity level, so in for the negative image you have to retrieve the intensity level of an image in this manner. The it produces the equivalent of photographic negative. This type of process is practically suited for the enhancing the white or gray details embedded in the dark region. Suppose you have the dark image where that image is dominant with the black color, and you want to extract the properties of the white and gray details from that image, so you can use the image negative or image negative transformation. So in this type of processing is practically suited for enhancing the white or gray details embedded in the dark region of an image, especially when the black areas are dominant in the sides. So in this case we can use the image negative. So these are the some examples of the enhancing the gray, or suppose this is the original image where these are the black color is dominant on the image, and you have to extract the properties of the white or gray color, so you can use the negative transformation. So this is one medical image, so you can use the image negative, so you will get the output image in this way. Next, second transformation is nothing but the log transformation. The first one is the negative image, and the second transformation method is the log transformation. These are the some basic gray level transformation. The general form of the log transformation, S is equal to C log of 1 plus R, where R should be greater than or equal to the 0. This transformation maps a narrow range of the gray level values in the input image into the wider range of the output gray levels. So whatever the narrow gray levels can be converted into the wide range of output gray levels. Okay, the opposite is true for the higher values of the input level. If there is a gray level higher in the input image, so it can be converted into the lower values of the output levels. We would use this transformation to expand the values of dark pixel. Dark pixel values is expanded in this processing in an image while compressing the higher levels of the image. So in log transformation there is a compression of the higher levels values and expansion of the lower level values. So the opposite is true for the inverse log transformation. The log transformation function is an important characteristic that it compresses the dynamic range of image with the large variation in the pixel values. Okay, so the log transformation uses to narrow the range of the gray level value in the input and provide the wide range of the output gray level value. And this is vice versa in case of the inverse log transformation. So the log transformation, one of the example is the nothing but the Fourier transform. So this is the one input image where this is the dot. If you want to expand this, you can use the log transformation. So after applying the log transformation, you will get this kind of the image. The range of the gray levels are is from 0 to 1.5 into 10 raised to 6 to the 0 to 6.2 range, where C is equal to 1. So you know the log transformation formula, S is equal to C into log of 1 plus R, and R should be greater than or equal to the 0. So you can apply the log transformation on the Fourier spectrum. The next transformation is method is the power law transformation. The power law transformation has the basic function S is equal to C into R raised to gamma, where C and gamma are the positive constant. The power law curves with the fractional values of the gamma. Sorry, it should be here. Values of gamma map a range of the dark input values into the wider range of the output values, with the opposite being true for the higher values of the input gray levels. So power laws gives the fractional values of the gamma map the narrow range dark input point or input values and wider for the output values. The opposite is being for the highest values of the input gray level. We may get various curves by varying the gamma values. So if you change the gamma values, you will get the various curves. The variety of the devices used for the input capture, printing and display responds according to the power law. The process to correct this power law response phenomena is called as a gamma correction. That if you change the value of the gamma, you will get the different value curves, and these the variety of the devices used for the same method, that is image capturing, printing and displaying the response. For example, CRT devices have the intensity to the voltage response, that is the power function. Next, the gamma correction is important if displaying an image accurately on the computer screen is of concern. So gamma correction is very important when the image is displayed on the computer. The images that are not corrected properly can look either bleached or out too dark. The color phenomena is also used this concept of the gamma correction, and it is being more popular due to use of the image over the internet. So gamma correction is very important for the displaying, the proper displaying of the image on the computer. So if the gamma is not corrected properly, then the image may be the bleached out or too dark. So this phenomena is very important because the wide variety of the image are displayed on the internet. So it is important in the general purpose contract manipulation to make the image black. We use the gamma greater than 1, and if the image should be the white, so we can use the gamma is less than 1. So these are the some curves where the range of the gamma is changed. So gamma is equal to 0.05, the curve will be like this. So if you increase the gamma, you will get the curve like this. So it is a power law. Next, the piecewise linear transformation function. The principal advantage of the piecewise linear function is that these functions can be arbitrarily constant or complex, but their specification requires considerably more user input. The form of piecewise function can be arbitrarily constant. The first form is the contrast scratching. It is the one kind of the simplest piecewise linear transformation function. We may have the various log contrast image, and that might result due to the various reasons, such as the lack of illumination, the problem of imaging sensor, or wrong setting of the lens aperture during the image acquisition. When the while taking the image from the many input devices, there may be the contrast, there may be the problem for like a lack of illumination while taking the image, or a problem of the imaging sensor, or there may be the wrong lens setting in the camera. So we can use this. The idea behind the contrast scratching is to increase the dynamic range. So we can change the gray levels in the dynamic range in the image being processed. When image being processed, so we can use the different gray levels in dynamically, so that image can be enhanced properly for the specific application. So these are some examples of the contrast scratching. So the location points R1 and S1 and R2 S2 control the shape of the curve. So this shape of the curve can be controlled by the two parameter R1 R2 and S1 S2. So if there are three conditions, if R1 is equal to R2 and S1 is equal to S2, the transformation is a linear function that deduces no change in the gray level. So there is a linear graph, so there is no change in the gray level. If your parameter R1 is equal to R2 and S1 is equal to S2. And if R1 is equal to S1 but S1 is equal to 0, so S2 will be L-1, then the transformation becomes the thresholding function and creates the binary image. That means there is two values only, black and white. Okay. Next, the intermediate values of R1 S1 and R2 S2 produces the various degrees of spread in the gray levels of the output image and thus affecting in contrast. Generally, the value should be R1 is less than or equal to R2 and S1 should be less than or equal to S2, so that the function is single valued and monotonically increasing. The next point is the gray level slicing. The highlighting of gray level slicing is nothing but the highlighting the specific range of the gray level. So some range gray level can be highlighted by the gray level slicing. Slicing is the part of the gray level. So that part will be highlighted by the in the process of the gray level slicing in an image of desirable. If that part is more useful and the specific part is applied for the or useful for the future, so you can use this. For example, when enhancing features of such masses of the water in the satellite image and enhancing the flows in the X-ray image, so there are these can be done by the two methods or two ways. One method is to display a high value of all gray levels in the range of interest and the low values for all other gray levels. So we can in first way we can highlight that part and displaying the high values for that range and low values for the other gray levels. And the second method is to brighten the desired range of the gray levels but preserve the background and gray level tonalities in the image. So in these two ways we can use the highlighting the gray level values for the specific range. The next one is the bit plane slicing. In the bit plane slicing it is important to highlight the contribution made to the total image appearance by the specific bits. Suppose that each pixel is represented by the 8 bits and the imaging that an image is composed of the 8 1-bit planes ranging from the bit of 0 for the last significant bit to bit plane of 7. For the most significant bit. In terms of 8-bit bytes, the plane 0 contain at the lowest order bits in the image and the plane 7 contains the high order bits. The high order bit contain majority of visually significant data and contribute to the more suitable details in the image. Separating the digital image into its bits plane and is useful for analyzing the relative importance played by the each bit of the image, and it helps in determining the adaptivity of the number of bits used to quantize each pixel, and it is useful for the image compression. So this can be done by this method. So this is the bith bit and this is the last bit. If this bit is 0, the next last bit is the 8 bit, and this is the some kind of the fractal of the image. So by processing this you will get this. So these are the some gray level methods, that is log, n root, power root, inverse log. These are the some figures where gamma can be changed on the CRT display. These are the figures for the medical where the gray levels can be changed. These are the satellite image where the gamma can be changed. So the gray levels can be changed. These are the transformation done, thresholding transformation, and we can change the gray levels depending upon the value of R and S1. It is example of the gray level slicing. Thank you.